goal to change the law after a driver who admitted to texting rear-ended Matt back in 2016, leaving him with a severe concussion. Kirsten O'Connor watched this morning's testimony. She's live with us in studio with more. Kirsten.
Justin, Matt is taking his experience and what he's learned from Florida families to drive his message home. Take a listen.
Now, my TV station and I set out to try to get results and push for this legislation when we found out how far behind we were. And we soon started talking to other people who were hurt by distracted driving. And very quickly, this push became less about me and my babies and more about others. You see, my babies were not in the car. They were not in front of a texting driver. But I have met people whose babies were in front of texting drivers, like Demetrius Braca, who has testified in many of these committees. I profiled a school crossing guard who was petrified that one day she would see one of her babies that she lets cross the street get hit by one of the dozens of texting drivers she sees every day out on the roads. I met a daughter whose 90-year-old mom was killed because a young man driving an F-250 dropped his phone on the floor and felt the need to reach down and grab it on the highway. It's about time the Florida legislature takes this crisis seriously. Give police officers the ability to do their job and give distracted drivers a good reason to put their phones down.
You can hear more from Matt in his live updates from Tallahassee starting on News 6 at 4. Justin.
All right, Kirsten, thank you. If you can't wait until then, if you'd like to know more now, just head to clickorlando.com. You can see more of Matt's testimony and how the initiative got started. Again, that's clickorlando.com/drivingchange.